Hi. I will talk about the Android programming tasks. The outline is given like this. Constraint layout, find view by ID, on-click listener interface, and binding events, post messages, intent usage, calling another activity with or without parameter, start activity for result will be explained. First of all, constraint layout. Constraint layout, one of the layouts used in the design. And it is a member of Android View Group. It allows us to position and size widgets in a flexible way. Constraint layout is available as a support library that you can use on Android system, starting with API level 9. In this constraint layout, there are currently various types of constraints which can be used. Relative positioning, margins, centering positioning, circular positioning, visibility behavior, dimension constraints, chains, virtual helpers, objects, optimizer. An example is given in the figure, and it can be accessed on the developerandroid.com. Constraints allow you to position a given widget relative to another one. You can constrain a widget on the horizontal and vertical axis. On the horizontal axis, left, right, start, and end size are used. In the vertical axis, top, bottom, size, and text baseline are used. The general concept is to constrain a given side of a widget to another side of any other widget. Here you can see, in order to position button B to the right of the button A, in the next slide. Here you can see the example of this. And this tells the system that we want the left side of button B to be constrained to the right side of the button A. Such a position constraint means that the system will try to have both sides share the same location. So button A and button B shares the middle sides. These are some constraint properties which can be used on the widgets. Layout constraint left to left of, left to right of, right to left of, right to right of, top to top of, top to bottom of, bottom to top of, bottom to bottom of, baseline to baseline of, start to end of, start of, end to start of, end to end of. In this example, here you can see left to right of constraint usage. And the bottom B is layout constraint left to right of constraint is linked to button A. Find view by ID is a method returns the layout widget's instance object. The return value is in view class type. So we need to use cast. Casting is used. In this example here, we first of all call text first name. And this widget located in the design XML file can be accessed, and the object reference is located on the text name variable. Here, text view casting is used to get all of the members of this text view. In Android programming, there are some listeners. One of them is on-click listener. So it's an interface, and it is defined in AndroidView.view. It is an interface definition for a callback to be invoked when a view is clicked. There is a public method on-click in this interface. So if you want to use this listener, you need to overwrite this on-click method. OnClick is called when a view has been clicked. And we need to bind this event to one of the widgets. So different types of usage can be binding methods can be used in our Android programming. So what are they? There are different ways to implement binding an event method, such as defining the property in XML file, implementing view on click listener in your activity or fragment, and defining new anonymous view on click listeners. Here you can see this example defines the method binding in the XML file. So you write directly the method name, send message. This method belongs to the activity class. So you need to define this method on the Java code. And you set the name of the method in the XML layout. This is the other next example. And it implements the onClick listener interface. How? In our activity class, we implement this onClick listener by writing this on the definition of the class. And on the bottom, here you see with a box, you need to override onClick method. And also on the onClick method, this button has a binding method, set on click listener. Set on click listener, the parameter this is given. This means main activity. So pressing the button, the capture will be the main activity will capture the event. The next usage here. We can define a new anonymous onClick listener class. So in the onClick method button has set onClick listener has used, and in the parameter we give a new implementation. We give a new class. This class override the onClick method. So a new operator is used here. That view on click listener is called. A new class definition is defined in the parameter of the set on click listener method. And toast messages. Toast messages are used in Android applications to provide simple feedback to the user. Toasts disappear after a timeout automatically. An example is given. First of all, we give three parameters to the toast make text static method. And this give us an object. And when you call the show method, it displays this message on the screen. So three parameters are used. The first one is the context. In this part, an application context is given. And the next is the text, the message. What you want to give to the user. And the last parameter is the duration. There are two constants defined in the toast class. One of them is the length short, one of them is the length long. So you need to give the third parameter as a duration parameter. Intents are used in the Android programming, and they are asynchronous messages, which allow application components to request functionality from other Android components. An intent is a messaging object that can be used to request an app from another app component. Intents allow you to interact with components from the same applications as well as with components contributed by other applications. For example, an activity can start an external activity for taking a picture. Explicit intent, implicit intent, use. So you can define two different intents. You can use intents to launch another activity, to return extra data from sub-activity. You can start a new service. You can send broadcast messages. You can display a list of contact of list view. There are two call for the intent. One of them is explicit, one of them is implicit. So what is explicit intent? An explicit intent is an intent where you explicitly define the components component that needs to be called by the Android system. An explicit intent is one that you can use to launch a specific app component, such as a particular activity or service in your app. Here, an example is given. So next activity is a specific component, and calling this activity needs an explicit intent usage. Here, implicit intent is described. The implicit intent is the intent where instead of defining the exact components, you define the action. You define directly the action that you want to perform for different activities. An implicit intent specifies an action that can invoke an app on the device to be able to perform an action. Using an implicit intent is useful when your app cannot perform the action, but other apps probably can add. You would like the user to pick which app to use. There is no specific component. So here you see, we use a set action method of the intent. First of all, we initialize the intent. After we give the parameter as an action. Action sent is given in this example. Maybe calling a dial, maybe calling a camera, take picture, etc. Or opening a new web page. All of them can be called by using implicit intent. In an intent, there are two pieces. What are they? Action and data. If you want to start a new activity, you can use an intent, and you can use start activity method statement. In the start activity statement, you need to give intent parameter. Also, you can start an activity and you can get the feedback. If you start activity for result, you need to give an intent. Also, you need to give a request code. Results can be read by on activity result event. You need to define this event method on your activity. On the next activity, in this sub activity, if you want to finish it and if you want to return, go back to the first activity, finish method is used. And if you want to send data, you need to use set result method. The transfer data are the result code and the data parameters of the on activity result method. Request code parameter determines which activity returned. And extra data can be transferred by intents. Data transferred between two activities are accessed using intents put extra and get extra methods. Extra data values are inserted into intent by using put extra. We need to give a name as a key and a value. Value can be changed, maybe boolean, string, integer, etc. And different, here you see, get string extra, get byte extra, get bundle, get double, get boolean extra. All will get the value of the extra data. If you want to use an intent to start a service, you need to call start service. A service is a component that performs operations in the background without a user interface with Android 5 and later. You can start a service with job scheduler. For more information about the job scheduler, we can see it in the API documentation. But previous versions, we can start a service by using methods of the service class. You can start a service to perform a one-time operation such as downloading a file by passing in an intent to start service. The intent describes the service to start and carries an extra and necessary data. A service is an application component that can perform long-running operations in the background and it doesn't provide a user interface. Another application component can start a service and it continues to run in the background and even if the user switches to another application. Additionally, a component can bind to a service to interact with it and even perform inter-process communication. an example. A service can handle network transactions, play music, perform file operating, input-output operations, or interact with a content provider, all from the background. There are three services in Android: foreground service, background service, and bound service. A foreground service performs some operation that is noticeable to the user. For example, an audio app would use a foreground service to play an audio track. Foreground services must display a notification. Foreground services continue running even when the user isn't interacting with the app. What about the background service? A background service performs an operation that isn't directly noticed by the user. For example, if an app used a service to compact its storage, that would usually be a background service. Bound service. A service is bound when an application component binds it to it by calling bind service. A bound service offers a client-server interface that allows components to interact with the service, send requests, receive results, and even do some across processes with inter-process communication. A bound service runs only as long as another application component is bound to it. Multiple components can bind to the service at once, but when all of them unbind, the service is destroyed. An example is given in this slide. A foreground service call. Here, notification, intent, pending intent is defined. So start foreground is called and notification here. What is it? A notification object. So it is an example for the foreground call. And here we can see the pending intent and notification intent. A notification intent gets two parameters. The first one is the context of the activity by using this example activity class, the next activity class. In the pending intent, here you can see get activity, pending intent activity. It's a different intent. It's a specialized intent. So in this get activity method, there are four parameters. In the notification set latest event info, we give first this context after get text message, after the other message, and pending intent as the last parameter. Another service implementation in this slide. This is defined in the application. It's a special service which is defined in our application. So its name is find as my service, and the class definition is given like this. So there are two methods have to be overridden: on start comment and on bind. We can put extra comments what we want to do in this service. What about calling this service? We need to use an intent, two parameters. The first one is the context, and the next one is the class of the service as the same which we used in the activity. What about the bottom? Here you see, by using the context, you need to call, maybe this is defined in the activity, maybe an application context, you need to call directly start service. Thank you very much. It's finished. See you in the next lesson. Please subscribe.